Welcome to another PLC programming tutorial for the beginners. In today's tutorial, we will see how to program a PLC for the traffic signals. Before starting today's session, I would like you guys to please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials. A traffic signal has three lights: green, yellow, and red. The green light indicates that the traffic can move and proceed through the signal. The yellow light indicates proceed with caution. Red light indicates traffic must stop. Now let's discuss the PLC wiring for these light indicators. The green light is connected at Y0 output of the PLC. Yellow and red lights are connected at Y1 and Y2 PLC outputs respectively. There are four steps in the traffic light sequence. Step number one is to turn on the green light for 30 seconds. Step number two is to turn on the yellow light for 2 seconds. Step number three is to turn on the red light for next 30 seconds. Step number four is to turn on the red and yellow lights for 2 seconds. After the step number 4 is completed, again the program will go to the step 1, and this program cycle continues. Let's see the programming for the today's tutorial. You can download this program and the link is in the description box. In the first step, we will turn on the green light for 30 seconds. In the first rung, we insert the normal close contact of the timer T3. The timer T3 is the timer to reset the complete cycle. We will discuss this timer in the end. Now, this normal close contact of the timer T3 will start the timer T0. The set point for this timer T0 is 30 seconds. We will use this normal close contact of this timer T0 to turn on the green light Y0. When the 30 second timer is over, it will open this normal close contact T0 and will turn off the green light Y0. First step programming is completed here. In the next rung, we will use the normal open contact T0 to start the T1 timer for 2 seconds. The normal close bit of the timer T1 will turn on the yellow light Y1 for 2 seconds. This is the programming for the step 2. In the third step, we have to turn on the red light for 30 seconds after the yellow light turns off in the second step. To do this, we will take the normal open contact of the T1, and when the T1 timer is over, it will start T2 timer for 30 seconds. We have inserted the normal close contact of the T2 timer to turn on the red light. So when the T2 30 second timer is over, it will open its normal close T2 contact and it will turn off the red light. Now the third step programming is completed here. In the last step, we have to turn on the red Y2 and yellow Y1 lights together for the 2 seconds. In the next rung, we start a timer T3 for 2 seconds with normal open contact of T2 timer. We insert the normal close contact of T3 timer in the step 3 to turn on the red light Y2. So the red light will remain on until the 2 second timer T3 is over. Same way, we will insert the normal close contact of the timer T3 and the normal open contact of T2 timer in series with each other to turn on the yellow light Y1. So by doing this, yellow and red lights will turn on for 2 seconds. Now the programming for the fourth step is also completed here. One last thing remaining is that we have to reset the timers in the last so that this program can restart its cycle. To do this, we will just put a normal close contact of the timer T3 in the first run. Once the last timer T3 is over, it will open up this T3 normal close contact in the first run. It will reset the complete logic and set the timers back to zero. And it will start the program all over again and again until the PLC is powered on. Let's upload this program and see how does this program works. As you can see that the program starts and it turns on the green light for 30 seconds and the car starts to move through the signal. After the 30 second timer T0 is over, it will turn off the green light and the timer T1 will turn on the yellow light. After the 2 second timer T1 is over, it will turn off the yellow light and start the 30 second timer T2. The T2 timer will turn on the red light for the 30 seconds. Once the T2 timer is over, it will start the 2 second reset timer T3. It will turn on the red light in the step 3 and yellow light in the step 2. Once the T3 timer is over, it will turn off the red and the yellow lights and its normal open contact also open in the wrong one. It will reset all the timers and a cycle starts again. So this is how we can program for a traffic signal lights using only but timers. We can merge ladder logics to program two or more traffic light signals. That's the end of the today's tutorial. Please share, like, and subscribe for more video tutorials. Till next time, take care and goodbye.